Oh, hi, I'm Anthony Reece. Excuse me. Oh, I'm feeling sad and gloomy. Nobody likes me. Nobody will hire me. All my coaches tell me that I'm no good and say I should go get a real job at Burger King. Everybody says that my demos are no good. All my peer-to-peer mentoring groups told me I was terrible. I pay all of the play-to-pays. I get in casting meetings now, all these job offers, and I never get hired for nothing. Oh, nobody likes me. I have a terrible voice talent. I should just blow my kids' college fund at Vegas or something. I have better odds of getting success there than landing any jobs. I'm a terrible voice talent. Everybody tells me that. Nobody likes me. Is this you? Oh, Lord have mercy. Okay, now, don't get me wrong. I am totally sensitive to the struggles of the everyday working voice talent. I've been there, did that, and then some. Trust me, everybody I know has their own pain stories they can tell you. However, maybe it's time for you just to simply refocus your voiceover services. We're going to take a look at four different areas that you need to maybe refocus, readdress, to reignite yourself as a voiceover talent. You got to remember something. Voiceovers is not a get-rich-quick scheme or an MLM marketing type of project. It is a voiceover service. You are a sole proprietor. You are the commodity, the distribution network, the marketing chain, as well as the salesman. So let's take a look at what you need to do to refire yourself up as a voice talent. One of the first things that I tell all of my colleagues, associates, and students of the art who have been around the voiceover industry for a while is to don't have any shame when it comes to taking a mental break. You know, sometimes going after auditions, constantly casting, doing cattle calls, as we say, replying to auditions, playing the game, can be very frustrating, obviously, and it can get to the point of where you get basically burnout. So there's nothing wrong with stepping back for a week, maybe a couple weeks if you can, and don't do anything. Don't touch your voiceover service, your studio, nothing. Take a complete mental block. I think you're going to find that harder than actually doing so, because we're addicted to it. Once you have the bug, as we say, it's like a drug. You got to be around the mic or in the room or in the booth or in the studio. However, the first thing that I tell everybody is don't do anything rash. Don't take any drastic steps. Don't walk away from your career. Don't flush the toilet. Don't sell the booth. Don't eBay or Craigslist the microphones. Take a few minutes, think about it, and turn those few minutes into a much needed break. That's the first thing that I recommend. Now, once you've taken that mental break, you've come back fresh and ready to go, let's take a look at what you should do next. Caffeine does the body good. One of the first things that I do is I reevaluate myself. You know, when I get to the point of where I'm feeling the burnout blues as a voice talent myself, I go to my room and look at all the awards lined up across the top of my, just kidding. Truth is, there isn't any but one. But anyways, thank you, Gary Lester. Reality, back to reality, back to life, back to, that's what we do too. Get back to reality. The first thing we do is reevaluate ourselves. You know, I did a podcast a while back for voices.com where I talked about being true to yourself, mirror, mirror, it's called. And the whole idea was to be honest with yourself as a voice talent. Whether you're a vocalist, an actor, a singer, an athlete, or what have you, you have to sometimes be willing to face the man in or the woman in the mirror. Sometimes it takes you to be honest with yourself and reevaluate your strengths and your weaknesses. Once you know your strengths and your weaknesses, you can focus on those strengths by reevaluating what has landed you work in the past. What are the compliments and good positive input that you've got for what areas of your voice? Are your strengths promos? Are you a better narrator? Do you supply better broadcast stuff than you do children's stuff? What are your strengths? Once you can identify those strengths, you need to build on those, make those a niche, and make those your X factor, or like I tell my students, your USP. In business terms, a USP is unique sales proposition. In the voiceover industry, I like it to be your unique sound proposition. So your USP is what's going to be your strength. You can also focus while you're not focusing on the strengths, marketing-wise, on getting better at the things that are weak. Training, ongoing coaching, ongoing workshops, ongoing seminars, and all that are fine. But at the end of the day, you have to take the techniques, the input that you are getting that's constructive, and apply those regularly on a daily basis, practicing the areas that you are weaker at. In other words, one of my weaknesses is, wait, do I have weaknesses? No, I'm just kidding. One of my weaknesses is I'm not really that patient at long form narration. You won't find me accepting audiobooks anymore. I can't stand constant redundant reading. So I build and push and try to focus more on the good side of me, the good side of my talent, the strengths of my talent. The weakness side, the weaker things, those are an ongoing exploration. And you've got to get to the point of where you can separate the two. Now, let's look at the next thing you should do. You're no good. Who told you you could be a voice talent? Where'd you get those demos made? I bet you've been coached by a few people, haven't you, that are not of the union status. These are the kind of things that you got to throw out the window right now. You know, once you have taken a mental break, you've reevaluated your strengths and your weaknesses, and you've come to terms with really who you are and where you should be at as a voice talent. You got to let all of those naysayers and haters and hate mongers and whatever, buddy, blow them right out the door. Fly right past them. You know, have you ever been to a concert and heard the one dude that's going, "You suck, man. I can play better than that, man." And the guy goes outside and gets in like a 1974 Volkswagen or something and goes to work delivering pizzas. Nothing wrong with delivering pizzas, but you get what the analogy I'm painting is that who is he to be pitching and teaching and or coaching or mentoring? The reality of the matter is a lot of people tend to have their own opinion and think that they are the chosen ones to critique and approve who shall and who shall not be knighted as a voice talent. You know, that is not for me, any coach, period, to say. Now, if there's somebody who obviously has a serious lisp or a serious overbite, or they're talking like they're so broke, they're tighter, well, come on, it's pretty obvious then they have no business doing voiceovers. But who's to say they can't make a living doing testimonials? Who's to say that they can't be a great character actor? The reality is, you are in charge of your own destiny. Sponge as much as you can off everybody. Get all those negative hate mongers and throw them to the left of you and blow on right through and stay focused. You can be the best voice talent you can be. Will you make $1 million? Who knows? Can you do it at Vegas? Who knows? Can you do it in voiceovers? Who knows? If you start a car wash detailing company or a chiropractic clinic, are you going to be successful? Who knows? However, it is not a job. Voiceover and voice acting is a career. It is a lifetime commitment. It is not a learn how to play the guitar, and if I don't get signed to a label in a year, I'm going to quit and walk away. You commit and you do not quit. Okay? So the reality is, all of those consultants, trainers, teachers, mentors, so be it, they know everything. They've been chosen and they are the anointed ones, as Hannity says. You just blow right through those people. Good quality coaching, surround yourself with positive influences. Find peer-to-peer groups that are going to support one another, not tear each other down. And at the end of the day, you will be the one that determines your destiny. Stay focused and stay the course. That's the next thing. What else can you do? Let's take a look.
You
You know, I wish I was as gifted and blessed to be able to have the golden million-dollar answers for everybody who's feeling discouraged about their voiceover service and/or voiceover career. The truth of the matter is, it's all perseverance. It comes down to being well-trained, being prepared and educated about the industry, knowing how the industry ticks, understanding how to make sure that you have a good, solid branding image in place. That includes a personal website, not just a pay-to-play web page, your own domain or website, your own marketing tools via email, business cards, and the old brick-and-mortar conventional way of handing out and mailing stuff, the ability to network and socialize on social media. Have a social media page on Facebook, have a LinkedIn profile, have a YouTube channel, even if it's just audio playing back, created to be video with still picture, your brand or your headshot. The marketing package should consist of your own website, your pay-to-play subscriptions and other listings so you know where you are and have your name out there, keeping connected and socializing and taking names and numbers, auditioning, casting, responding to castings, and ultimately staying on top of your demos. Your demos should be a priority. Do not put your demos in the back seat as a third, fourth, fifth priority. Your demos can make or break you. When you do an audition and somebody listens to your audition, 9 times out of 10, they're going to go to the demo so they can hear what else you can do. It's equally as important. Anybody who tells you otherwise are full of it and they're telling you not the true facts. You want great demos to complement your great voiceover auditions. More important than anything, create a management, a time management system. Put in X number hours a week on your refining your image and your look and your brand, marketing yourself, contacting and doing auditions, following up those that you have name and numbers on. And ultimately, at the end of the day, think out of the box. Think guerrilla marketing. Be creative. Get up and believe. Positive attitude. Surround yourself by positive influences. And at the end of the day, again, remember, this is not a job. You are self-employed, entrepreneurial, and you have to ultimately see the vision that you will be successful, even if you only land one job a month. If you're looking to pay all your bills and win the lotto and hit it big, you better go union, move to LA, Hollywood, New York, and go and bang heads with the A-listers. Because the reality is, there's money to be made, there's jobs, but the truth is, you cannot sit back and wait for the phone to ring. I don't mean to scold you, but I am being honest and telling you hard love truth. This is a competitive field. Those that are fully packaged like a professional, who present themselves like a professional, who continually audition and contact people and network and take as much constructive coaching as they can. Blow off the hate mongers and all those who tell them they can't. Those are the ones that ultimately succeed. It is your destiny, and you have to take control and work your way through the slime. If you do so and stay positive, you too will have a positive outlook, and ultimately, it will pay off in the long run. So stay focused, stay the course, reevaluate yourself, take a mental break if you need to, refocus on your strengths, work up those demos, and stay the course. And again, it's ultimately your destiny, and you are in control. Other than that, I wish you the best of luck. I hope this reignites you a little bit, makes you think about some things that you should possibly be doing, and if worse comes to worse, relights the rocket just a bit. All those hate mongers, you tell them to take the back seat and plow through them. I'm Anthony Reece with VO 101, and here's to you on your voiceover journey. Good luck to you.